Good morning, students. Today's amazing facts about Harappan civilization. Human history is the accounts of rise and fall of civilizations and empire. Human settlements first began on the banks of the fertile river plains in four different parts of the world. These river valleys became the cradle of human civilization. The Mesopotamian civilization flourished on the river banks of Tigris and Euphrates. Then the Egyptian civilization flourished on the river banks of Nile. Then the Chinese civilization flourished on the river banks of Huanghe. The Indus Valley civilization flourished on the river banks of River Indus and its tributaries. Of these ancient civilizations, Harappa civilization holds extreme merits due to its outstanding town planning. This feature was not found in any of the other contemporary civilizations. Every ruin has a story to tell, a story of its glorious past, a story of what brought about its presence, a story of what it might would been to what it has become. So the ruins of Harappa were first described by the British East India Company soldier and explorer Charles Mason in his book. When he visited the Northwest Frontier province, which is now in Pakistan, he came across some mysterious brick mounds. He wrote that he saw a ruined brick castle with very high walls and towers built on a hill. This was the earliest historical record of the existence of Harappa. Later, in 1856, when engineers laid a railway line connecting Lahore to Karachi, they discovered more burnt bricks. Without understanding their significance, they used the bricks for laying the railroads. In 1920, archaeologists began to excavate the sites of Harappa and Mohenjo-daro. Now, let us have a look of the cities and buildings of the Harappan civilization. The cities and buildings built during the Harappan civilization reflect their outstanding construction skills. The cities were divided into upper part and lower part. The upper part are built on the raised platforms and it is known as citadel. A citadel is a fortified structure designed to provide the protection during the battle. This part include the public buildings, then the granaries, then the great bath and other special workshops and religious buildings. In the lower part, the people lived and carried out their professional work. Whenever the city was attacked or threatened by floods, the inhabitants of the lower city found refuge in the citadel. The granaries are found in the citadel mount of Mohenjo-daro. Below the granary were a brick loading base from which the grains are raised into the citadel for storage. One of the most important features of the Harappan city was the swimming pool, popularly known as the Great Bath. The structure of the Great Bath is an example of their engineering skill. This brick built structure measures 12 meter by 7 meter. So it measures 12 meter by 7 meter and it is about 3 meter deep and it has steps leading to the bath and surrounded by set of rooms. There was also an arrangement to send hot water to the pool. The water was supplied by a large well which is found in the adjacent room. There was also a corbel drain for discarding the water. Houses and streets of Mohenjo-daro in the lower city was properly planned. Here, streets run straight and at right angles to each other. The main street is about 10 meter wide. Houses were built on both sides of the street. Many houses were at least two-story. Houses were built of bricks and had thick and strong walls which were plastered and colored. The rooms were flat with windows and doors made up of wood. The bathroom were built on one side of the house and drains connected to the street drains. The street drains run along the sides of the street and were lined with bricks to keep it clean. Some houses have wells. These houses belong to rich merchants and high-class people. Other people who worked as laborers at granaries lived in a small one-room quarters. There are also evidences that people domesticated animals such as goats and dogs. We also get to know about the clothing of the Harappan people through some of the evidences. The finding of the clay spindles such as cotton weaving and yarn spinning was practiced by women at home. It is believed that women usually wore skirts and men covered themselves with long pieces of clothes. Both men and women were fond of ornaments. Men wore armlets and women wore bracelets and necklaces. Ornaments made up of beads of shells and gold silver were used. System of weights and measures were also well developed in those days. The weights, measures of various shapes and sizes with accurate grading are found at many sites. They are cubical and spherical in shape and are made up of jasper and agate. Then, small clay carts are found at some of the Harappan sites, imply that bullock carts were in use. Then, on the basis of information gathered from the Harappan seals, seal impression, terracotta and metal figures, cemeteries, etc., we can come to a conclusion that worship of mother goddess was prevalent in the society. Then, other traits of later Hinduism such as worship of Pasupati Shiva seal, sacred animals, trees, etc. were practiced by the Harappan people. Also, a large number of figurines depicting number of various yogic posture indicate the practice of yoga by Harappans. The Harappans were expert craftsmen. The most famous art piece of Harappan civilization was the bronze dancing girl discovered in Mohenjo-daro. Small clay carts, then copies of carts drawn by oxen, painted jars reflect their interest and skills in art. The Harappan people had developed great skills in pottery. They decorated their pots with designs depicting snakes and flowers, etc. Potteries were more refined and decorated with red slips and black paints. Clay button seals, then various weapons and variety of painted potteries have been discovered from Harappan sites. The Harappan culture lasted for more than 1,000 years. The world's earliest urban civilization came to an end around 1300 BC. Natural calamities like floods, terrible epidemic diseases, and attack by wild animals are the suspected reasons for their decline. Although some aspects of the Harappan culture continued after their decline, those who succeeded Harappans knew nothing of city life. Thus, decline of Harappan culture was a negative event in the history of India. So children, I hope you are benefited with this information. And iron was unknown to the people of Indus. So Harappan civilization belongs to Bronze Age. Thank you.